Hi, I'm Jeremy Reef with RLR Inc. in West Point, Nebraska, and today I'm going to go over how our operation benefits from accurate boundaries to improve our efficiency and performance in the field. We trace our boundaries with an 835R John Deere Gator, utilizing a Starfire 7000 GPS globe with SFRTK accuracy, and a 4640 display running the 22-2 update. One of the first steps in boundary tracing is to understand your equipment and implement widths. So here we have a 1775 NT corn planter, 24 row, 30 inch. And because it's 30 inch, we're gonna split that number in half to 15 inches. Come up to our first row, measure out 15 inches, which is here. So when we go to do boundary tracing, it is going to place the corn planter at this line in reference to the boundary. But because it has this extra weight bracket, we need to keep track of that number, which is 26 inches, for when we go back to the gator to add our rod to avoid trees and power poles. Once we're done here, we gotta check other equipment and other implements. So here we have a DB60 15 inch. Come up to the first row, split the number in half, 7.5 inches. So again, here is where it's gonna put the planter in reference to the boundary. We have a marker here, so we're gonna come out to the end of the marker, which is 30 inches, and keep track of that number for when we go back to the gator for our rod to avoid objects. We like to have the outside tire be the boundary. So we measure from the center to the outside, which is 32 inches. We subtract 15 inches, which lines up perfectly with our steering wheel to give us a frame of reference. 15 inches from 32 is 17 inches, so we add 26 inches to that, which means we place the rod 42 to 43 inches from the center of the gator to the end. No different than a tractor, we need to make sure our measurements are correct on the gator. So here we are verifying that our dimensions are entered. Next, we're going to check the orientation of the globe is set and that our height of the globe to the ground is entered, followed by a TCM calibration. Here, we are recording a curve continuously. When approaching an object, we want to make sure our rod does not touch, since this means an implement will impact the object at a later time. When approaching low-hanging trees, it's always best to pause, drive around the tree, and resume. Two benefits exist. One, you do not lose signal quality, and two, you do not destroy your expensive receiver. So here's a scenario of creating an interior non-passable boundary. We have the center point of a pivot. Go in here, add an interior boundary. It's not passable. Same settings to the left. Start recording. I'm just gonna drive around this thing as best as possible. Come out a little ways, just because it's where we have the pickup when we fill it up with fuel. And then get back to my home point. Hit save. There we have an interior non-passable boundary. Here's a quiz. Is livestock passable or non-passable interior boundary? They are definitely non-passable. Here are a few examples of us utilizing a recorded boundary along with boundary fill as the guidance line, passive implement guidance, and AutoPath recording. Another advantage of boundary recording is being able to operate in poor viewing conditions. Here I am making a pass along an uneven fence line. With passive implement guidance, my second pass follows perfectly. Followed by my third pass in the opposite direction.
One thing to always remember when approaching a tree or power pole is to never make sudden or abrupt changes around the object, as the planter or sprayer cannot react as fast as the gator. These power poles were recorded using the pause and resume function. Here we are utilizing boundary recording to go around an object with a 120-foot sprayer boom. Another advantage of accurate boundaries is when we top or side dress with dry fertilizer. Now we do not have to count rows or try to guess where 45 feet is from the property line. A new feature we are going to utilize this spring is snapping a guidance line to an interior non-passable boundary. This will allow us to plant or spray on one side of a center pivot perfectly without creating a partial pass. First, we will add a guidance line, enter in the desired implement width, which in this case is 120 foot, snap to one side of the boundary we want, we will define our heading of 260 degrees, name the guidance line, save it, and push it out to the display. With a good boundary, you can take full advantage of boundary control to use turn automation or to minimize passes through a field. Here are two adjacent fields that we own where both boundary passes line up even under limited viewing conditions. Utilizing a good boundary, we can receive an alert when we might go outside the boundary while using turn automation. No matter the implement type, anyone can utilize the full John Deere tech stack of boundary recording, passive and active implement guidance, AutoPath, turn automation, and soon autonomy. I hope you enjoyed this overview of boundary recording. A key few points to remember: pause and resume as much as possible, as this will provide better results. Don't make abrupt or sudden changes around an object, as the tractor, sprayer, or combine cannot react as fast and may cause an impact. Double-check your measurements when entering them into your display, as an incorrect number can have a negative impact and poor results. A boundary may change due to a removed tree line, washed-out waterway, or shrub overgrowth, so this may require redoing a boundary recording. Be patient with boundary recording, as the results will have a positive impact long-term. Thank you, and have a wonderful day.